Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. I hope you guys are doing extremely well. So here I am with another topic, that what are various sources of fatigue in microwave communication. So at first I want to tell you that this type of question can ask in a short question or as a notes. So here I explain it as the view of short question or notes. And one thing I also want to say that it is not taught by any teacher. It is not copied from any another notes. It is a self-made notes of mine. So do not judge it. It is a simple way to give you idea about it. So what are various sources of fatigue in microwave communication? If this type of question they will ask, you should write in a simple way as I wrote. So I am going to explain it. At first you should write that fatigue types. What are the types of fatigue? So it having two types, large scale fatigue and small scale fatigue. Large scale fatigue having two types, path loss and shadowing, and small scale fatigue having three types, fast fatigue, slow fatigue, multipath fatigue. And multipath fatigue having two types, flat fatigue and selective fatigue. So now going to explain it, that is large scale fatigue. I'm going to explain it here. Large scale fatigue, large means that is a big, anything big, bade paimane pe. So this refers to the attenuation of signal power due to the obstacles between the transmitter and receiver. So it refers the attenuation of signal power due to obstacles between what? Transmitter and receiver. It also covers the attenuation and fluctuation of signal when the signal is transmitted over a long distance. Long distance means in a kilometer. Kilometer distance if it we will travel, then we can say that it also covers the attenuation and fluctuation of signal when the signal is transmitted over a long distance. Kilometer. So now coming on small signal fatigue, here is explanation. This refers to the fluctuation in signal strength and phase over short distance and small duration of time. Small scale, it means chote paimane pe. This refers to the fluctuation in signal strength and phase over short distances. It do work as a long distance and in this short distance and small duration of time. It is also called relay fatigue. Small scale fatigue affects almost all forms of wireless communication. Wireless communication means mobile phone and extra. So wireless communication affected by what? Small scale fatigue, and overcoming them is a necessity to increase efficiency and decrease error. So having three types, fast fading, slow fading and multipath fading. Now we are coming on path loss. Path loss means if you travel longer distance, then there will be path loss, otherwise it is decreases. So in the case of path loss, it refers to the attenuation when a signal is transmitted over large distance. Here I told you that in the case of large distance, there is attenuation when a signal is transmitted via the signals spread as they propagate through the medium. As the distance increases, the energy per unit area start decreasing. And shadowing means shadow. This refers to the loss in signal power due to the obstructions in the path of the propagation. And having fast speedily. It occurs mainly due to reflection for surface and movement of transmitter or receiver. It occurs mainly due to reflection for surface and movement of transmitter or receiver. Slow fading means it occurs mainly due to shadowing, where large buildings or geographical structure obstruct the LOS. So, and multipath fading, it occurs when a signal reaches the receiver, whenever signal reaches to the receiver from various path, it travel various path when any signal is transmitted from transmitter and it reaches the receiver from various path when multi-path propagation takes place. So it is a simple explanation of this. As I told you that if they will ask question related to this as a short question or notes, then you can write this answer. It will be more than enough. I hope it will be helpful for you, and thank you.